The season of sniffles is just around the corner. Is chicken soup and tea with honey on the menu? Making sure your food is rich with nutrients is one way to maintain your adaptive immunity. Our immune system defends us against all pathogens. There are two types of immune systems present in our bodies, innate and adaptive. Innate immunity is present since birth. It reacts to any infection quickly. Your body builds adaptive immunity over time. It has a memory component and responds to various infections specifically, but slowly. In today's video, let's look at all immunity-boosting nutrients. Should you be eating oranges and lemons during the flu? Why do you need vitamin D? We're discussing all this and more. Let's begin with the most important one, vitamin C. There's nothing better than a good dose of vitamin C to boost immunity when the weather starts changing and the viruses are at their peak. Not long ago, vitamin C helped us to maintain health during the COVID-19 outbreak. It's a water-soluble vitamin occurring naturally in vegetables and fruits like oranges, lemons, guavas, papayas, cantaloupes, red and green peppers, tomatoes, sprouts, spinach, and strawberries. Having 75 to 90 milligrams of vitamin C can increase the production of white blood cells and help in the rapid healing of wounds. Studies confirm that vitamin C contributes to boosting both innate and adaptive immunity. A vitamin C deficiency could make you fall sick due to infections. If your diet lacks this nutrient, it's a good idea to take a vitamin C supplement too. Next, drinking water will keep you in top shape. Going without water, even for a short time, might be dangerous. Drink at least 2 to 3 liters of water every day. Grabbing a can of soda can be tempting, but the caffeine can dehydrate your system. Water is the only super hydrating, calorie-free beverage that will also aid in preventing several non-communicable diseases linked to poor nutrition. This essential nutrient is a powerhouse of minerals like magnesium, calcium, potassium, sodium, and zinc. Water is necessary to produce lymph, which transports white blood cells and other cells required for strong immunity throughout the body. A cup of green tea with lemon, fresh coconut water, or mint-infused water is fantastic for boosting the immune system. But foods with high water content, like celery, cucumbers, and watermelon, can also help when you're not in the mood to chug down a glass of water. You'll also need ample beta-carotene. This compound is necessary for producing vitamin A, which is essential for sustaining vision, stimulating growth and development, and preserving the integrity of epithelium in the body. Vitamin A is an anti-inflammatory necessary for boosting immune function. Additionally, having 700 to 900 micrograms daily has proven therapeutic benefits in managing some infectious disorders. For a healthy dosage of beta-carotene, think about including carrots, sweet potatoes, pumpkins, dark green leafy vegetables, apricots, and squash in your diet. Since vitamin A is fat-soluble, research has shown that eating vitamin A-rich foods with good fats will help in its absorption. Carrots cooked in butter or along with hummus make a fantastic immune-boosting combination. You can also use avocados or olive oil in the dressing for your green salads. Next up, prepare your body to combat illness with vitamin D. This nutrient is fat-soluble and performs various vital functions in your body. The ability to absorb calcium and keep the bones and teeth healthy is noteworthy. Research shows that 600 to 800 international vitamin D units can influence innate and adaptive immune reactions to viruses, bacteria, and other pathogens. Increased vulnerability to infection is linked to vitamin D deficiency. This nutrient is vital for people with an autoimmune disorder. An autoimmune disease is the condition where the body's immune system destroys healthy cells. Vitamin D supplementation can lessen the side effects. Salmon, canned tuna, fortified cereal, milk, egg yolks, and mushrooms are all sources of vitamin D. In addition, your body can produce lots of vitamin D with just 20 minutes of exposure to sunlight 3 times a week. Moving along, don't forget about antioxidants. The naturally occurring antioxidants in foods can stabilize free radicals. Free radicals are the obnoxiously harmful compounds produced when you're exposed to UV light, cigarette smoking, and other environmental contaminants. They're incredibly detrimental to your health since they can alter your DNA, enzyme, and membrane structure. Antioxidants have the capacity to neutralize free radicals and safeguard the structural integrity of cells and tissues. Antioxidants reduce inflammation and aid in the battle against infection, too. Foods like berries, citrus fruits, dark-colored veggies, and dark chocolate are rich sources of antioxidants. Also, don't forget green tea. It can improve your immune system's performance. It contains amino acids, which may increase the power of your disease-fighting cells. The next immune booster on our list is vitamin E. Research has shown vitamin E is a fat-soluble vitamin that has antioxidant properties. Getting 15 milligrams of this vitamin is essential for people older than 14 years old. Good skin and healthy eyes all depend on vitamin E. This nutrient guards against cell damage, too. Vitamin E pills have gained popularity as antioxidants recently, but you can always depend on natural sources like peanut butter and other nuts and seeds like almonds, sunflower seeds, and hazelnuts in your diet. Next, do probiotics help to build immunity? Yes, of course! So have a yogurt cup every once in a while to stay healthy. It'll have a ton of probiotics. Live cultures in probiotics keep your gut healthy and strengthen your immune system. Live cultures are often referred to as good bacteria because these microbes help your digestive system absorb nutrients and eliminate harmful bacteria. The probiotic microbiome serves as an additional defense against dangerous fungi and bacteria. Studies say probiotics guard adaptive immunity against persistent insults and inflammation of your gut. If you stay away from dairy, you can also have other fermented foods like kombucha, kimchi, sauerkraut, pickles, and tempeh for loading on probiotics. Zinc is another mineral crucial for adaptive immunity. Studies have shown zinc to be the gatekeeper of the immune system. Zinc ions play a role in controlling both innate and adaptive immune cells' intercellular signaling pathways. Zinc also produces new immune cells. It's a unique mineral that our bodies cannot generate or store. Your immune system may get compromised by even slightly reducing zinc levels. Its deficiency can cause your immune system to become stagnant and less effective. Additionally, it strengthens muscles and aids in magnesium absorption and hormonal balancing. Men require 11 milligrams, whereas women need 8 of zinc daily. The highest source of zinc is oysters, although additional alternatives include crab, clams, lobster, mussels, chicken, turkey, red meat, and beans. Although some bread and fortified cereals also contain zinc, animal-based diets promote the best absorption. Selenium also seems to have a powerful effect on immunity. This vital mineral receives very little attention. In addition to triggering immunity, it controls immunological reactions and inflammation. Selenium is a trace mineral. Your body only requires 55 micrograms of it daily. It communicates to your immune system when to work and when to relax. It's also essential for the body's inflammatory response and for stopping infections. Brazil nuts provide more than 100% of the daily value of selenium in one nut. However, eating too many can be harmful, so limit yourself to one or two per day. Tuna, halibut, sardines, meat and liver, poultry, and cottage cheese are foods that have selenium. Next is vitamin B6 for a robust immune system. Vitamin B6, or pyridoxine, metabolizes carbs, amino acids, and fats. It's also essential for nerve function and the production of new, healthy red blood cells. Vitamin B6 is key in keeping the skin healthy and maintaining the lymphatic system. According to research, a vitamin B6 deficiency impacts immunological responses that are humoral and cell-mediated. Men and women require 1 to 2 milligrams of vitamin B6 daily. Dried yeast, liver, and other organ meats, whole grain cereals, salmon, and legumes are all excellent sources of vitamin B6. Due to the widespread distribution, deficiencies are uncommon unless you eat junk food. Vitamin B6 is water-soluble. Your body drains any excess out of the body via urine or sweat. But consuming excessive amounts of vitamin B6 supplements might cause vitamin B6 toxicity. So go easy on the supplements. Another noteworthy vitamin belonging to the B-complex group is B9. Folate, or B9, aids in creating DNA and RNA, the genetic materials of cells and healthy red blood cells. It's also significant for breaking down homocysteine, an amino acid that can exert harmful effects on the body. You require 400 micrograms of folate every day. Raw green leafy vegetables, asparagus, broccoli, fruits, liver, and other organ meats, dry yeast, fortified bread, pasta, and cereals are all excellent sources of folate. But 50 to 95% of the folate is destroyed during extensive cooking. The body can more easily absorb folate from enhanced foods and supplements than from naturally occurring folate in food. Your body also requires folate to develop the fetus's nervous system. That's why women who are pregnant or who may become pregnant should take 600 micrograms, slightly more than the average value of folate supplements. Are you trying to improve your diet? That might be a challenge. Choosing the correct foods can be difficult because there's so many healthy alternatives available in grocery stores. Check out 20 nutritious foods you should be eating every day, or 9 of the most nutrient-dense foods on the planet. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn how nutrient-dense food can build your health. Which nutrients do you have every day? Let us know in the comments below.